Good morning, students. Today I'm going to show you how to create a Google account. So first of all, open your web browser, and then you can type google.com on your address bar, web browser's web address bar. Then on right hand corner you can say Gmail or sign in. You can select one of these. If you go to sign in, you will get something like this. So from there you can select create account for myself, or else you can go to Gmail and then you can select create an account. So here I'm using Sinhala. I get this, so I'm going to change it to English United States. I can change the language. I can select my preferences. Then I can type my details like first name and the last name. Then I can select a username which I prefer to have. So I'm just typing which I like to have. Most of the time if you try to get type your first name and all, then it may not come here, because most of the time they are already been taken by other people. So once you have put a username, then you can type your password and the confirm your password which you should use to log into this user, this Gmail account. So here password should be 8 or more characters with mix of letters and numbers and symbols. So you can type your password here, more than 8 characters, and you can see a closed eye here. So if you click on this, it will be open, which means whenever you, whatever you are typing will be visible. So if you just in a private area, then it's okay, you can open this, or otherwise just close it and just type the password which you like to type, which you like to take. So when you are typing your password, since you can't see it, to get a confirmation that you have typed which you typed to thought, there's a confirmation button. So purposely I have done it mistakenly, and here also I am going to put like Chandiman, just to show you how it will come. I put it like this way, and then see, confirm my password. I have changed a little bit, so that's why they are giving. So I can type it again to check to get the correct confirmation. Now when you are getting this, if you get something like this, better to type password and then confirmation again. Sometimes what you have thought might not be typed earlier. So here you can see, even I tried to take Chandima, it's not available. So I'm going to type which I thought earlier. So yeah, it should be period, not comma, because we can use periods but not commas. So I'm going to, yeah, you can have that email address says. Then here it says phone number optional. This is recovery. If you just forgotten your password, or unfortunately if you forgotten your username, you can recover it by this. So, and for account security also. So if you want, you can type a phone number here, it's an optional one, and a recovery email address also. If you, now since I'm doing this for students, you can type your parents email address, or if you have already taken another email address, you can type it here. So I'm not going to, I'm just skip this, it's optional. Then you can type your date of birth here, and then the gender you can select, and then you can go to next button. So here you will get something called the terms and condition, privacy and terms. So you can go to I agree part. But when you are doing this, even though I have not get here, sometimes you may get a part which where you have to put your phone number, and then to your phone you will get a verification code, and then you have to put that verification code there to create your username and password, the Google account. Okay, here without doing that I got this. So again I'm telling, in some cases you may get another screen before this to put your phone number, and once you put your phone number, you'll get a verification code to your phone, your phone number, your parents' phone number, you will get a verification code to your phone. So you have to take that verification code and put it there, then only you can process for completing the Google account. Now here you can see welcome, then you can select the way you can see the emails and all. I'm just say default is okay. Then you can go there. Once you go there, you can see the things you can do. You can get your Gmail account to your mobile, learn how to use Gmail. The tutorials are there, step by step tutorials. So you can change your profile image if you want. So things you can do, you can just move here and then can just learn the things. So this is an email account. You can see you will, whatever the emails you will get to the inbox, and then starred ones. Now if I want, this is an important one, I can just click on this star. So those starred emails will come onto this star folder. Then sent items, once you have sent an email, now you can compose email and then you can send it to somebody else. And now if I say, if I just typed one of my other email addresses, and if I say okay send, even though there's nothing I have to put, okay test, I put test, and then I'm sending it. So it's sent, it says message sent. Now you can just go to send button, you can see what you have sent is there. So they are keeping a record of what you have sent. And then the drafts, if you are doing something, if you are writing but you are not completed the email, then it will be, you can save it into drafts. So again you can add more folders, you can keep it nicely with folders. And see, this is how the interface of the email account once you go inside. And on right hand corner you can see your Google account, your name and the Gmail address. And then before that you can see Google Apps. There you can see, you can go to Play Store, Google Play Store. You can download another apps, various apps to Androids, or if you can make the your desktop as an Android interface like using BlueStack or Knox. And then there's Drive. Yeah, you can save your documents and various documents where you want to share. And Google free space, some free space. And then if you need more than that, 15 GB I think for the present. So if you need more than that, you have to purchase it. Then this is where actually we consider most with this. These are the documentation, like you can create documents, you can create spreadsheets, you can create PowerPoint presentation slides, and so many things are there. And especially we are considering on these classrooms and these doc sheets and slides things. So with next lesson we'll discuss about that. So till that, have a nice time and have a good day, and especially take good care of yourself and your family.